Hello, my name is Kiuk Chung. I'm a software engineer in Pytorch's research to production, or otherwise known as the R2P team. Our main goal in R2P is to make Pytorch a delight to use in production. Today, I'm here to present to you a project called Torchx that we open sourced recently, specifically for this purpose. In short, Torchx is an SDK for quickly building and deploying ML applications from research to production. It enables this in three very easy steps. The first step is to define or choose a component. A component is just a fancy term for a flexible job specification. The class definitions for a component are defined in the Torchx Specs API, but in most cases, you actually won't have to worry about defining your own components, since Torchx ships with a set of built-in components that suffice most use cases. But should you need something more custom, Torchx's core APIs allows tons of customization at well-defined extension points so that even the most unique production applications can be serviced without customizing the whole vertical stack. Once you've defined or chosen a component, the second step is to see the component in action by running it as a job. We realize that adopting a new technology in production takes development resources. And the good news is that you can get started with Torchx at no added infrastructure setup cost. This is because Torchx works with popular ML schedulers and pipeline orchestrators that are already widely adopted in the industry and deployed in production. So chances are you're already running a scheduler that Torchx supports. Lastly, production jobs often run in the context of a pipeline or a workflow with both upstream and downstream dependencies. So for example, a training job may have to wait for data to arrive, and similarly, inference has to wait for the latest trained model. Torchx components can be converted into pipeline skip stages of a supported ML orchestrator and run as a stage in existing or new workflows. In the next three slides, let's take a look at each one of these steps in more detail. A component in Torchx is a Python function that returns a well-defined job specification called an appdef. An appdef is a Python data class that holds all of the necessary information to run an application as a job. Let's take a look at some examples. On the right-hand side are two components, train and train dist. Both train and train dist are Python functions that take parameters and returns an appdef. Train specifies a single node job that runs the entry point my/trainer/main.py in a container created from image my/docker-image. Additionally, it sets environment variables, rank and role size, to 0 and 1 accordingly. And it also requests that these containers run with resource requirements equal to those of a P3 8x large instance type on AWS. On the other hand, train dist is a distributed data parallel version of train, where we ask the scheduler to run n nodes number of containers, each container running n proc per node number of trainers. But unlike train, rather than spelling out the appdef, it's using a built-in dist-DDP component. This makes things much more concise for train dist, despite the fact that it is actually asking the scheduler to run a more complicated job. The concept of components exists in Torchx because components essentially parameterize an appdef. The parameterization criteria is completely your choice. For example, you can parameterize components by functionality or by development stages. In train dist, we decided to parameterize the built-in dist-DDP only on the job size while hard-coding the entry point, image, and host type. Built-in components such as dist-DDP, serve, and HPO can be composed into custom components or run out of the box, as we'll see in the next slide. In the previous slide, we saw what components looked like. Now let's take a look at how components are submitted as jobs. The Torchx runner is responsible for submitting a job given a component. And at a high level, the component is evaluated to obtain an appdef object. The Torchx runner has integrations to popular schedulers like Kubernetes and Slurm, and it also includes a local host mode to help you quickly iterate on your components and applications on your local dev desktop. It's also easy to add a custom scheduler by implementing a few methods in the Torchx scheduler interface. The two CLI examples on the left-hand side show how to run the custom train dist and built-in distdp components from the previous slide. And notice that the list of arguments we pass to the components are different, since they're parameterized differently. Distdp is more generic since it takes the image and script as parameters, whereas train dist is less flexible but simpler. The -s Kubernetes option tells Torchx that the components are to be submitted as a job onto a Kubernetes cluster. To run the component on different scheduler, all you need to do is to pass a different -s option. So for example, to launch on Slurm, you would pass -s Slurm instead of -s Kubernetes. It's also without saying that in addition to the CLI, there's a programmatic API to the Torchx runner, so that you can build custom programs that launch components. So finally, we get to pipelines. And the production story wouldn't be complete without talking about how to run components as part of a larger workflow or pipeline. In Torchx, you can convert your component into a pipeline stage by using the Torchx pipelines adapter. Just like the runner does with schedulers, pipeline adapters in Torchx support existing mainstream pipeline orchestrators. Once you've converted the Torchx component as a stage in the target pipeline's DSL, you can go about defining the workflow purely in the pipeline orchestrator's language. The example on the right-hand side shows how a Torchx component can be plugged into Kubeflow pipeline's workflow. First, the app dev is materialized by evaluating the component function. Next, the app dev is converted into a KFP op using the component from app method from the Torchx pipeline's KFP adapter module. The DAG itself is purely defined in Kubeflow pipeline's lingo. A nice side effect of this design is that you can plug in Torchx components into existing legacy pipelines, which reduces the cost of integration since Torchx components can be used with existing legacy pipeline ops. And with this, we've covered the three basic steps to start using Torchx in production. One, define or choosing a component. Two, running it as a job. And three, converting it to pipelines. So hopefully you got a good sense of what Torchx is and how it can help accelerate research to production for your organization. We've open sourced Torchx 0.1 with a collection of MVP built-in components, schedulers, and ML pipeline orchestrators. And we hope that with your interest and contribution, together we can build a vibrant production ecosystem for PyTorch. Thank you.